Hi, I'm Roland Alderbell, and we're in Neptune's Kitchen. A friend of mine introduced me to a book called The Primal Scream by Arthur Janov. And this, for me, was like the new religion. I totally bought into the theory 100%. And instead of trying to write pop songs about nothing, I had a theory and a philosophy to write about. And it enabled me to express all my angst and everything else. And that's really how Tears for Fears started. And Kurt and I were both from quite sort of difficult backgrounds. I mean, sort of, it's quite a lot of disturbing violence in mine. And we felt that this was a brilliant vehicle for us to sort of express ourselves. And that theme went throughout virtually all Tears for Fears records. There were always references to the past, to the inner world, and well, we sold about 17 or 18 million albums. I don't know what the singles sales are, but we were, I guess, a little bit rare in the fact that we did break America and we broke it big. Something happens when you play live. There's no record company, there are no journalists, there's nothing, there's just you and the audience. People who like playing music, people who like listening to music, and something happens certain nights where you are just transported into this incredible place. I hated what we were after Songs from the Big Chair because we were so big, and it was like, I thought, well, wait a minute, there must be more to life than this. And I certainly felt there was more to me than making that kind of robotic sort of techno Germanic sort of music. In 1996, I was on tour, Tears for Fears, and I just had enough. And I didn't know what I wanted to do next. So the next 3 years, 4 years was spent experimenting, not quite sure whether I wanted to do another record. In the 90s, I did two Tears for Fears albums. One was called Elemental, and the last one was called Raoul and the Kings of Spain. When I'd finished Raoul and the Kings of Spain, for me, it was the perfect Tears for Fears album. I kind of had everything I was trying to write about, trying to express, trying to explain, and I put it in a very poetic form. It wasn't adolescent, it was mature. I'd become a father, and I could therefore write about myself, about my child, and about my own father, linking generations. For me, I was really, really pleased with that album, and I didn't really feel the need after that to go back and write any more about the past, about my inner world. I really wanted to start experimenting in a more abstract fashion. I wanted to make music for music's sake. And I didn't want it to be a Tears for Fears album. It had none of those concepts, none of the theories. And so I thought the simplest thing to do would be just to put it out as myself. I was luckily enough asked to produce a female artist called Emiliana Torini, and her energy and a sort of fresh approach, I think that's what set me off again. It made me realise that she felt she had nothing to lose. She just wanted to make a record, and I think luckily I got some of that energy. I feel right now that there's much less pressure. I feel like this is more fun, and I think this is, for this time in my life, it's the right thing to do. We had a working title for a long time, which was Buffalo Standing, which is a line from Kill Love. But again, I just thought it didn't sum up the album, because the album's quite up-tempo and it's quite vibrant and there's a lot of energy. So I was looking for something that would describe that. And rather sadly, it was 1:30 in the morning and we got a phone call. It was from my wife, it was from the hospital. And her dad had collapsed. And just as she was leaving the house, she screamed down the hallway. Tomcat screaming outside, and I thought, that's it. With this album, it was really around the time where drum and bass started to make itself known. People like Ronnie Size, Fotek. I just fell in love with the sort of how manic it all was. It's all computer-based. You can cut things up, you can spin them around, you can reverse them, you can distort them. And it's never been more easy. Every day I have a different favourite. I think because Low Life was sort of finished with one of the last tracks, I was sort of really into that for quite a while. Because again, I felt it was quite different from anything I'd done in the past. But there's lots I like. I think this is perfect for a live situation, this album. And, you know, again, I've got sort of quite a nice amount of songs I can delve into the history of what I've done. These are the days of futures by design.
So does your faith give you powers?
This situation, you know, signed to an independent label, just using my own name, it's just, there's so much freedom. It is so unburdened, and I can't quite believe it. I've got a blank canvas. And before, I had the history. And what was I going to do to counterbalance what I'd done before? This time I could do anything I like.